We are here at the bins. Really excited to be able to find a cart every time now. Like, literally, this place is full and there's still three rows of carts. But I decided to grab a cart, and I actually wanted to look at the books today. So I just came over to the books to give a little gander. I know some people like having these as like coffee table books, and I found some really cool books before, but I usually never really look at them. But I thought I'd do a quick little peek, see what's over here. Oh, R.L. Stein. If you can get like a bunch of them, I'm pretty sure those do well. Miller Band. Not a book. Oh, a family knitting book. Everyone can have a matching sweater. Fun. There's actually people in there. Okay, I think I'm gonna meander out to the main bins, see what I can find. What is this? Oh, is this like a Guinness, maybe? Okay, let's go see what else we can find. It's like a, smells like, I got a whiff of either cat pee or smoke, potentially. Vintage sheets. This is a nice quilt. I think they will do a flat price of $5. Ah, yes, this is a brand, but who? JCPenney, making the quilts. Nice quote, though. Okay. I just wanted to stop and see that. What is this? Oh. A costume? Are these those, like, make your butt look good? I don't know. Ignore me. Is this good? It's a cute summery dress. Vintage Eddie Bauer. Looks like it's reversible. Or maybe it's not. Maybe this is just... No, it's not reversible. JK. Medium. I don't think I want a massive jacket right now. Okay, let's carry on. This smells musty. Probably would be worth the pickup, but I just don't want to do smelly things. Thank you. is this monstrosity? Bathing ape? Is that what that says? Someone was very creative. It's very strange, but I'm gonna think about this. These are also expensive. Looks like it needs to be washed. That's strange. Tropical. Oh no. Kentucky, Ireland. These are super chipped. These are pretty. Ooh. It was $60 for a set of 26. Something. Don't look at my precarious glass. Felder. It's a print. It's really pretty. I have got so much art, it is oozing out. So I gotta let the art go. Thank you. looks like a very vintagey Disney Parks cup. Oh, I wonder if this is... No, never mind. Is this the top? No. Ignore me. Oh, someone needs a snack. Oh my god, this is so cute. Vintage. Okay, put that in there. So grandma's a box. Okay. Oh, here's another one. Betty Hebert Belden. Super crazed and cracked in a bunch of places. Versatile? He has a lid. Thank you. pretty. Like a little 70 pencil box or stuff. She's very dirty. Knickerbocker. Experience things. paper. Is someone's child. I mean, all pictures are, but like, I don't think it was sold at a store. Michael Delacroix. And he is $10. Are usually good. Oh, this one looks like it's had a very rough time. I don't know why I'm shoving everything in the top part. I don't know. Very strange. And she has seen things. Oh, really dirty. Looks like this is the tie bin. Hmm. music is strangely loud right here. It's cute. Look at that one. And the love of Pepsi. It's like everyone went home. I don't know, it's like you're really quiet in here. Which makes it hard for the music to be offset. There's no noises. Okay, I'm gonna move to a as noisy spot. Oh. the inside is tore up. I'll think about it, I guess. She would not be peeling really terribly. The logo is really, this is a really bad knockoff. And then the Gucci authentication number is on the back of this. Yeah. Another poor Gucci knockoff. I think I'm gonna get this as a Prezi. I think it's trying to look like ramen. Ooh, it smells. I have a mask on and it is potent. Missing that little stud. like a swim cap. Oh, yeah. I'm pretty sure that's vintage. Ooh, someone lost their eyelash. Mimicking Chloe. Do like a embroidery lot of like hankies, yada yada. I don't know. Wow, Estee Lauder. Thank you. hey, here is what we got. Everything looks very colorful, which I'm really, I love color. So let me just put some of this stuff down here. Ooh. Okay, well, let's just get up now. Okay, so here is the stash. Not a massive amount, but decent. I'm not upset with how much is here. Not a lot of clothing today, but some fun materials. This is a shirt, some bags. So overall, like, I'm happy. Why don't I start up here and then I'll just work my way down. This is, I think, a little vintage pencil case, like a 70s, 60 print, plastic. It's not in amazing shape, but it's pretty light, so it probably won't cost that much. I don't know. I like it. Next is a Tanned Toys Made in England little elephant teapot thingy, like plastic teapot. That. Not too long ago, I found a Apple beaded vintage coin purse, and it looks like today I found a strawberry. This one's in much better shape though. The Apple had some issues. But this one is very pretty. So we got that. A decent amount of glass today. Let me take this out. I don't know how you pronounce this. Kanken? Kanken? Sorry, I'm probably butchering it. But I know it's a very popular brand. When I was in Europe, these stores were all over the place. It does need a little bit of a cleaning. But yeah, it's a very popular bag or brand. This is like a super heavy duty cup, and it does have a brand. B-L-O. C-K? GK? Something like that. But very cool. I could only find one, but that's okay. I'm not sure if this is vintage, but it's a little milk bottle. And it says goat milk on it. So I'm gonna get that. Okay, what brand are these? Oh, okay. Let me find the plate. Okay. These are Nautilus USA eggshell. So I got two of the saucers and then the cups that go with them. They were selling the whole set for $60. I didn't take them all. I just took two of each. Okay, let me, oh gosh. These things are gonna like pop out the side. Okay, I got it. I got four of these. Fine porcelain china, Christine, Japan. There's like a blue floral print with like a silver accent. And then, I should not be allowed to get glass. I'm just gonna say that. Or breakable. Okay. Noritake Ireland Morning Jewel saucer, and then the little teacup They were selling 46 piece for $100 at Goodwill. I'm just gonna leave this dress. Okay. Leave that. I'm gonna put some of these back here. Okay. Put this on top for a little cushion. Okay. Next is a very retro vintage. Does it have a brand? Oh, it's Lane Bryant. Shirt with a partial zip, but very like 60s, 70s. I love it. Let's put that in there. Okay, next is, I think it's vintage. Not 100% sure, but really colorful pencil pattern fabric. And the brand was Northcott. We got that. Another really fun. Just swatch of fat, well, not swatch, but like a little thing of fabric. I'll look to see if I can find a brand on that, and I'll contemplate if I really want to get that one. Next, a vintage scarf, super fun, colorful. I think the brand on this is Echo, E-C-H-O. Next, a very strange pair of Levi's that say bathing ape. I have no idea. They look uber crazy, but you know what? I'm gonna give it a go. Maybe someone wants and has been looking for a pair of jeans that say bathing ape. So, we're gonna get them. Okay, next, another little scarf. Looks like the tag was torn off, but like purples and blue, kind of Aztec-y. Got that. Next is a just crocheted tiny little crossbody. Super colorful, rainbowy. Next, I think it's a hanky, but it was so pretty. I was saying before I might do like a lot of like linen, different linen. Next, a vintage floral swim cap. Because I wanted all the colorful things today, obviously. So we got that. Okay, next, I don't think there was a brand on this, but it's just like a raffia large tote in like a navy blue. I'm not sure if they're leather or faux leather handles, but we got that. We also got a doily. I think they're strawberries, maybe? Or maybe hearts. Anyways, something like that. But just a tiny little guy. Next, a tiny vintage little suitcase that says travel time, grandma's or bust. Super duper cute. I love it. Next, a Winnie the Pooh tote bag. I think the brand is just Pooh. Looks like he needs a little, like, fabric shaving. Next, a 9 West. Small bag. Let me see if it's leather. No, it's not leather. So I may not get this one. If it was leather, I probably would. This one I need to look up. I think I sold it. I have sold it before, yeah. Capizio. It's a vintage kind of bowling satchel. Inside's a little sketchy. But it's a fun vintage look. So I'll probably get that one. A vintage wallet. It's monogrammed. It is St. Thomas Pigskin. There's room for your passport, foreign money, rail tickets. I just thought that was cool. A lucky wallet on a chain. Not really a chain, but you know what I'm saying. Wallet on a string, like distressed look. That we got a Stella, I believe it was, yeah, Stella and Dot clutch. It's like a magnetic closure. It looks like they do have a place to put, oh no, it has the chain, so it can also be a shoulder bag. Next, a Coach leather handbag. The inside is in rough shape, but I might just give it a go. Got that. A leather. Ooh, very difficult. West Mount Top Green Cowhide and Genuine Snake Skin. So I don't think this can be shipped globally because I believe some countries will confiscate this. I know Canada does because I sent something with a lot less snake skin and they confiscated the bag. Next is a orangish. It looks like there's some fading. Kind of see. Coach. Looks like it was a factory outlet bag. Orangey. But I'll still get it. It kind of looks like a ombre or ombre type of look. Next, another vintage. Called Tan Sack. Not sure if it's leather or not. But we got that. I've stopped picking up a lot of ties because they're super slow sellers, but these ones were kind of unique, so I decided to get them. This is a Pepsi tie for the Pepsi lover in your life. Next is a poo. We need the poo tie. Vintage, made in Korea. This one I was gonna look up, I just didn't get a chance. Equus? Equus? Like birds. This I'm getting as a gay gift. Or if they want to use it for real, they can. Next, a Marvel The Incredible Hulk tie. Because it was made in the US, so, and it's silk. So, I don't know, got that. Next is a scarf. Oh, maybe I won't get it. It has quite a few runs. It does look like the edges are hand-rolled, though, but I'll probably put that back. Next, is a Bagelini. These sell pretty well for me. I need to check the zippers because there was a few zippers on some older ones I got that didn't work. So I need to remember, check the zippers. Next, another little shoulder bag crossbody. That's just like a little compact woven bag. And then a vintage paint by number. The paints are in there, and here are the pictures. I'm not sure if I'm just gonna get these or if I should get the box and the paint. The paint's probably not usable, but these vintage paint by numbers are popular, so I'll look it up and see what exactly I should do, how I should get it, but I'll be getting something from the paint by number. And then the paintbrush, the bristles were all tore out, so I just left that behind. But yes, there we are, another successful go. I would be curious if the Bathing Ape is like some popular artist. I'm gonna look that up when I leave, actually. Probably just someone on the street who paints on pants, who knows. But like always, all of my stuff is posted on eBay, Poshmark, and Mercari. And there will be more bins videos coming soon because it's an addiction that needs to be fed. So we're gonna feed it. Anyway, thanks for coming along. If you could give this video a thumbs up, it helps the algorithms, and we'll see you later.